A lot of your major GCs out there went and said, look, we're going to go from type 1 protection to type 2 protection because it gives us better protection out there, right? So this whole lateral impact protection thing is, we talk about lateral impact. So that's that kind of that straight on hit like this, right? But one of the things that lateral protection may or may not help with is angled impact. So when you think about an impact, you know, 85% of all impacts happen laterally.
This video is brought to you by PIP Global Safety, leader in personal protective equipment. If you're looking for real-world insights, tips from leading industry experts, the latest trends in products and technology, you've come to the right place. From MSC Industrial Supply, this is Tooling Up.
Hello and welcome to Tooling Up. I'm your host, Toni Neary, and I'm so glad that you've joined us today. Before we get to today's guest, let's take care of a little bit of business. Go ahead and click those like and subscribe buttons, and that way you'll never miss an amazing episode like the one you're about to see. All right, everybody subscribed? Great. Today, I'm excited to be talking about advanced head protection with John Britt. He's the product sales manager at PIP Global Safety. John, thanks so much for joining us and welcome to Tooling Up.
Thanks, Toni.
And John, I love to hear how our guests found their way into the industry and how they became the experts that they are. So can you tell us a little bit more about how you got into the safety business?
Sure, I'd be glad to. So originally, I was in the chemical transportation business. We cleaned tank cars, intermodals, rail cars, things like that. And I was responsible for environmental health and safety, amongst a million other things. But so I used a lot of PPE, did a lot of hazard assessments and what have you. So give me a really good background. And then that was in the Midwest when I decided I wanted to leave the snow and the cold and move to Florida. I said, oh, I got to find something to do, right? So all that I had learned and being an industrial end user, I put to use and got into safety distribution. So I spent a number of years in safety distribution down here in Florida. And then there was an opportunity for me to join at the time, which was North Safety, who had just been acquired by Honeywell Safety Products, the part of Honeywell. And so I joined their organization as a territory manager there and was selling the full complement of products there. During that time, we acquired other companies like Sparian, which gave us UVEX, Miller, Howard Light, Fiber Metal, brands like that came into the portfolio as well. Spent about 10 years with Honeywell, and then there was an opportunity for me to move over to PIP, which was a competitor of Honeywell at the time. So I went over to PIP and was a regional sales manager to start with PIP. And for the last 4 years, I've been product sales manager for above the net protection.
I love it. And obviously, you have a lot of experience and passion about keeping people safe. And as some of our viewers may already know, Honeywell's PPE business was recently acquired and is now part of the PIP family. Can you tell us a little bit about PIP and that journey to where the organization is now?
Yeah, absolutely. It's one of those really good stories, right? So it's been around, PIP has been around for 40 plus years now. It was started back in 1984. By Joe Malott and Wilson Tao. They started the company on $2,000 and selling some cotton inspection gloves into the U.S. market. Over the years, they continue to expand their business and continue to grow. They partner with folks like Dyneema and Kevlar on some of the materials out there, joined a partnership with ATG, one of the premium glove suppliers for the world, and JSP, and really started to expand their offering from just hand protection, arm protection, to, you know, head to toe. Rapid growth in the 2000s. I mean, they doubled the size of the company year over year, you know, from 2000 to 2017. You know, the footprint expanded into not only North America, but also Europe and Asia. To continue that growth, in 2018, they partnered with private equity, you know, to give them the recapitalization ability to continue to grow the business. They purchased Westchester Protective Gear in 2019, which kind of gave them a new platform, if you will. And then again, through the different PE partnerships that we have now with Odyssey Investments, between the two PE companies, we've got 19 global acquisitions, which really gives us one of the largest PPE portfolios in the industry. And to bring it back to the comments you made there about acquisition to Honeywell, again, that doubles the size of the company again, position us to be one of the largest true pure play PPE companies in the world. And we combine many trusted brands out there to, you know, a lot of expertise to better protect workers.
And I think that truly speaks to that commitment to growth and protecting workers in an ever-evolving industry. Speaking of which, it feels like there's been a major shift in head protection. What's driving some of these transitions?
Yeah, so I mean, obviously head protection's been around since the early 1900s, and it's evolved up to a certain point. But then, you know, about 1950s, it kind of stopped, if you will, on there. It was, you know, thermoplastic or you know, plastic type head protection out there. And most of that head protection on there, there's two types on there. There's an ANSI type one, ANSI type two. Type one's going to be top impact only. So that's only rated for the top of the helmet here. There's nothing else inside besides the suspension that works in conjunction with that shell. And that's been used primarily in construction and industry and, you know, a lot of different sectors for a lot of years. Type 2 head protection has been around for a while. So type 2 head protection is also going to be that top of head, but also going to give you lateral impact. So if you see here, he's got like this foam EPS liner inside there. So that gives you not only top of head protection, but also front, back, and side.
John, can you take a little bit of a deeper dive into just the different industries and the importance of this lateral protection and how the evolution of technology is really following that trend?
A lot of your major GCs out there went and said, look, we're going to go from type one protection to type two protection because it gives us better protection out there, right? So this whole lateral impact protection thing is, we talk about lateral impact. So that's that kind of that straight on hit like this, right? But one of the things that lateral protection may or may not help with is angled impact. So when you think about an impact, you know, 85% of all impacts happen laterally. So now we've got technology out there like MIPS. MIPS is Multi-directional Impact Protection System. It's a brain protection system that we incorporate into some of our helmets here. The purpose of that is this liner inside of there will move about 10 to 15 millimeters. And the purpose of that is for an angled impact, either from an object or a slip, trip, and fall, it'll allow the shell to move independent of that system. So by doing that, it allows that rotational force to be dissipated and less of it's transferred to the brain.
And I have to say, I have a son who's a hockey player, and it's never the hit that you see is the hit that gives you the impact. So, and talk a little bit about the necessity for really starting to creating this complete safety system, and not just the fact that you've got the technology in there, but how are you making sure people are wearing it? Because PP is great as long as it's worn, right?
We are seeing more adoption out there, right? Because we've got our Traverse here, which we're featuring today, is our number one selling product now at PIP. So one of the things that you notice here, it comes with a chin strap, right? So I could put the best head protection on my head there, but if it comes off my head from an angled impact or a slip, trip, and fall, I've got no protection whatsoever, right? So chin straps are definitely coming into play, right? And also, like I said, with some of the technologies to adjust that rotational force reduction. Lots of accessories for them, right? So for the ones that need to have eyewear, you can add eyewear to the helmet as well. So it drops down here. We've got face shields for it. We can put earmuffs on the for hearing protection, different type of sun protection here, either from the neck shades or things like sombreros.
Well, I think your passion, the technology, the innovation that we're looking at is just absolutely amazing. We want to keep people safe and get them going home the way that they left in the morning, right?
Absolutely.
John, thank you so much for your time today and for your passion and expertise in the industry.
Yeah, glad to be here. Thank you. Appreciate it.
It was so great hanging out with John. And if you enjoyed our conversation as much as I did and want to see more discussions like this, please subscribe to our channel. To learn more about advanced head protection solutions from PIP, visit www.mstdirect.com/products/PIP-helmets. Thanks, and we'll see you next time on Tooling Up.
Want more insights and ideas to improve the efficiency and productivity of your operations? Check out the Tooling Up video playlist to hear tips that can take your company to the next level. And subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out.